must be, I mean, seeing this term first time, you must be reading. So it's very simple, made up of two words, pharmacone and vigilance. Pharmacone means drug, and vigilance means everybody knows, right? Be aware of the drugs. So, why I'm teaching this, because I have 10 years of experience in this particular field, and I teach many healthcare professionals like how to be pharmacovigilance, and now I'm moving to the general populations. So, moving ahead, I have a question to you. Do you think everybody takes medicine, right?
Yes.
Is anybody who has not taken medicine yet so far in their life? Everybody. Right? So, do you think the medicines you are taking are safe?
No, we don't know.
Allopathy
are not. We don't know.
Allopathy for sure.
Ayurvedic, what about?
Ayurvedic,
it's safe?
Need not.
Comparatively better.
So, we are not certain actually. Yeah. But we take these medicines because we do not have options, we do not know much. There are two sides of medicines. We have a lot of medicines. There are many which are in the pipeline today. Will be coming, and we have, you know, overcome lot of deadly diseases which were there 50 or 60 years back. Now they are not exist at all. So this is because of medicines, but there is one flip side of medicine also, right? It's not just with the allopathic medicine, but it's with the Ayurvedic medicine also, which we consider very safe. Most of the Ayurvedic medicines are being taken today. It's around 50 to 60% medicines, Ayurvedic medicines are consumed in India that are also having the problems. So like painkillers, many people take it very frequently, like you know, candies,
yeah.
Right? And antibiotics. So this, I know one guy, he just came to the hospital, he had some infections in the stomach, and he was given one antibiotic through injections, and suddenly after taking antibiotic, he fell down, collapsed, and he was on the verge of death. Immediately adrenaline was given to him, and somehow we saved his life. It was a very simple, he had little infection, but the problem was that he was aware that he has some problem with the some medicines, but he was not, you know, with the vitamin like all of us, and doctors were also not aware about it, that he has some problems, but he had the problem with particular type of antibiotics, that he was very sensitive to that. So that is the things, like, these are the complementary alternative medicines. There is one thing which is also available in Amazon, you can say, that is the purple corn flower, which is used for the normal cold, fever, headache. It may also causes asthma attacks. Also, we have problem with the food and alcohol. Many people take alcohol, right?
Yes.
So that also interact with the medicines. Sometimes, especially those who are the kind of chronic alcoholic, if they take paracetamol, that may cause liver damage. The paracetamol, which is considered as the most safe medicines. So we will see, like, this is some of the incidences. Sometimes we see, okay, it happens, I mean, it's normal kind of. But if we see the overall picture, what is happening around the world, we see the around the world, this is the statistics. It's the fourth leading cause of death, ahead of AIDS and other, you know, deadly diseases, cancer and all these things. You see the death ratio, and cost wise, if we see, here it is, in USA, it exceeds the cost of the medication themselves, the cost to prevent the ADRs. Burden of ADRs in India, we talk about India, we have very limited data about it because we are very poor. 1.8% mortality, and 7 out of 10 serious ADRs are not reported in India, even nobody cares. So this is the statistics. See, now the prevention, how we can prevent it or not. So this is the preventability rate you see here, and this is the median, this one. This is the preventability rate. These are the studies which are done in 10 years. So it has been shown like this. So this is what the preventability rate. Counterfeit medicine, recently in Jaipur, it was a big scam came out. The people were selling the counterfeit means duplicate medication, which just didn't have even.
Yeah.
It was like a fake currency. They were selling the tablets on the name of big pharma companies, but it was not like that. So there were no active drug ingredients in the medicines. Resistant to medicine comes up. It is mainly when we are not following the doctor's advice properly. It happens in case of antibiotics. Doctor says take it for 5 days. If you are well in 2 days, we just leave it. But because of that, what happens? Resistance develops, and now it has become the biggest problem agenda for the World Health Organization, and especially they are concerned about India because Indians are not following the antibiotic course properly, and that is leading to antimicrobial resistance. Prevent all this. So now the government came up. Government came up with the idea of like promoting the program, which is known as the Pharmacovigilance Program of India, wherein we are promoting the rational use of medicines, benefit risk analysis. This is the most important part, where your contribution work, your contribution in terms of reporting. Whenever anything comes up, whenever any problems comes up, we need to report it, and that report is introduced that get into the database, wherein we detect the signals, and from there we analyze and we take the decision. There was a lady, she was taking new slide whenever she had the pain, you know, body pain, so body ache. So she used to take the medicines, but every time she had the adverse reaction, gases were coming out from, and she was admitted. Last time when she was admitted, she was on the verge of death. But every time the severity increases, so we cannot avoid even a single small problem. So what we need to do, this tech can tell with you here. Yes.